Reishi mushrooms, otherwise known as Ganoderma lucidum, are a rare mushroom that grows at the base of deciduous trees like your oak, maple, and beech. It's also referred to as lingzhi and has been used in Eastern medicines for over 2,000 years. And what's special about them is that they claim that they can boost the immune system, fight cancer, and improve heart function. In this video, we will investigate those claims, as well as talk about the safety of reishi mushrooms. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions, as well as being the know when it comes to your health and wellness, and I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. Now, this video isn't to discredit Eastern medicine at all. In fact, what I can appreciate about Eastern medicine is the fact that it takes a holistic approach that looks at the entire body, spirit, and mind when diagnosing and treating illnesses and not just bandaging symptoms. But I think as you do that, it's important not to compromise evidence-based literature as well as scientific data along the way. The facts are that there is quite a limited amount of human studies on the effects of reishi mushrooms. And at the same time, there's also growing evidence to suggest that reishi mushrooms may be toxic and can cause health issues. And when we're looking at the claims of their use for, let's say, cancer, you find a number of people actually using it as a remedy for many types of chronic diseases, including hepatopathy, type 2 diabetes, neurasthenia, hypertension, as well as cancer, largely because of the findings that reishi mushrooms can suppress cell adhesion and cell migration of highly invasive breast and prostate cancer cells, which suggests its potency to reduce tumor invasiveness. The problem with that is that keyword here, suggests. Suggestion in the literature does not mean it causes that thing it's suggesting to actually occur clinically, if that makes sense. So in other words, I would like to see more research to back that up. Now the question is, whether or not we are going to get funding to do any of that type of research. And yes, I'm also not doubting that many breast cancer patients will continue to take it. In fact, there were 4,149 women with breast cancer who participated in the Shanghai Breast Cancer Survival Study who took reishi mushroom. What was both awesome and interesting was that they had better social well-being scores, but poorer physical well-being scores. So do you see the gap here? Secondly, let's take a look at the reports on immune system boosting, because a lot of people take it for the immune system. A lot of the products that you find mention immune boosting with reishi supplements, being promoted as immunomodulating agents, which can confuse a lot of people expecting a certain outcome to take place when they take these mushrooms, like expecting to fight off infection, bacterial and viral diseases, as well as the immunological pathways of cancer itself. What we do know is that the constituents in reishi mushroom have been seen to increase CD3, CD4, CD8, and CD56 lymphocytes, plasma concentrations of IL-2, IL-6, and interferon gamma, as well as natural killer activity, right? Those are the ingredients you need to boost immunity. And preclinical studies have established that the polysaccharide fractions of reishi mushrooms have potent immunomodulating effects. But take a look at this. However, clinical evidence for this is scanty. I didn't even know what that meant, the term scanty, and had to look it up. It basically means small or insufficient in quantity or amount, which is another gap. And in terms of their safety, for the most part, reishi mushrooms are tolerated just fine, actually. A few people have an upset stomach with them, which is why if you're trying them out, it might be better to take them with food. And in case you're wondering about the reports of liver toxicity with them, there have been case studies, I think two of them, where liver problems were seen when they switched to the powder form. Now, we aren't sure if it was the formulation itself that caused liver damage or the actual mushroom itself causing liver damage. Whatever brand of reishi you're using, you want to make sure that you get one preferably sourced in the US and has third-party testing to ensure that quality is there, and one that really has no other fillers, because a lot of the times you get these nonsensical fillers added into your supplements that just don't frankly need to be there. And of course, because the three major constituents in reishi mushrooms are its unique polysaccharides, peptidoglycans, and triterpenes, they do have interactions with your medications that utilize the same pathways in the body. These include your diabetes medicines, which can lower your blood sugar even more, your blood pressure medicines, which can lower your blood pressure even more, and your blood thinning medications, which can increase your bleeding risk. So definitely be cautious if you're taking reishi and you're on any of these medicines. If you're interested more about mushrooms, I actually made a lion's mane video that talked about lion's mane in complete depth here. Click that subscribe button if you found any value, and comment down below as well what your thoughts are on reishi mushrooms in general, because I know it can be a lot to take in. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.